E-paper displays are well suited for novel interfaces. Unfortunately, most e-paper displays either provide bendable capabilities or support color. With this work, we present the first platform that allows researchers to prototype with e-paper displays supporting both bendable and color capabilities. Building on the latest display technology from Plastic Logic, we introduce a battery-powered wearable toolkit that offers a wide range of real-world functions. To validate our approach and demonstrate its promising potential, we implemented 8 applications and started to test our prototype in the wild. And finally, take a glimpse into the future and discuss advanced visualizations, new form factors, and field studies. As a first step, we will briefly present the applications of our prototype. The activity app shows a person's steps by using the inertial system and visualizes color-coded height profiles using the barometric pressure unit. The weather app displays ambient temperature using built-in sensors. Further, we started to realize detailed views with advanced visualizations, precipitation curves or conditions, and are working on an integration of real forecast data. The mobile Dataverse app provides versatile, interactive visualizations. Based on our prior work, we continued research on interactive watch strap displays and explore how colored e-ink displays can further enhance this promising display ensembles. The notification app visualizes incoming text messages with colorful and expressive emoticons. The Media Controls app enables shortcuts for music player, presentations, or remote shutter control. Due to its cross-platform implementation, it is possible to connect to any Bluetooth-enabled device. The Pattern app presents an opportunity to turn the interface into a visual appealing accessory. The Workwear app builds the basis for discussing new fields of application with domain experts. Next, we will present step-by-step instructions for building our toolkit. As a first step, we will fabricate the curved housing. Therefore, download the 3D model, prepared for printing by slicing the case, and finally 3D print the housing with sufficient support material. After printing, it is important to remove all support material and sand the surfaces smooth to ensure that the display will fit and not be damaged. Next, we will demonstrate how to customize the housing surface. Depending on the desired finish, we use 2 techniques. Very flexible materials such as soot can be seamlessly glued, cut and folded. For more rigid materials such as book clothes, we laser cut easy to bond templates. For our design exploration, we created a set of different cases. To enable interaction, we decided for an explicit pressure touch. Therefore, we arranged 3 linear soft membrane potentiometers on a thin film. To capture pressure touch events, we created 3 adjustable voltage divider circuits that we sample with a microcontroller's analog to digital converter. Finally, we cover all contacts with heat shrink tubing and insulating tape to avoid short circuits. Next, we will install the screen and the pressure touch module in the housing. To place a module correctly, carefully slide the foil potentiometer in the housing from behind. Next, slide the e-ink display into the housing, using the slot on the side. Please take special care not to damage the display connector, and only apply force carefully. Finally, we will assemble and wire all electronics. To do so, first fold the contacts of the soft potentiometers to the side, then place and screw the EPD driver board. Next, slide in the microcontroller and solder all wires. Finally, connect the display flex cable and cover the electronics. To make the display wearable, we will manufacture an elastic band. For this purpose, we cut a piece and seal it with fire. Sew a connector tab, sew on a strip of Velcro, and finally attach the band to the display by using 2 screws. Make sure that the band holds strong. In order to power the system, Velcro attach a LiBo battery. Now it is time to program. Open the Arduino environment, connect the prototype via USB, and upload the program. Congratulations, you successfully built the prototype. You can now pair and connect the device to mobile operating systems like iOS or desktop environments. For further details, please refer to our paper.